Now, when you first meet me, you might not realize that my personality matches iced coffee, that my mental age is 71 years old, that I'm an ENFP, or I'm also a greyhound. If I was running, I guess it would be more obvious. We're fascinated with this idea of personality typing, but throughout history, it's been fraught with junk science and results that can't be replicated. So are all personality tests just wrong? Now, we've tried to explain personality from using everything from lumps on your head to your birthday. The signs of the zodiac are a surprisingly common way of personality typing, by trying to group people according to the month you're born. But we know it's not science. In a paper published in 2003, scientists looked at over 2,000 babies. Many were born at the same time on the same day. They called them time twins, and their development was monitored for decades. The research looked at things like anxiety, IQ, sociability, and even marital status, all things that astrologers claim to read on a birth chart. But they didn't have similar personalities, and astrologers who attempted to read their signs did no better than chance. Everyone grew up into their own unique personality, and the stars had nothing to do with it. Some early psychologists took a different approach. So you may have heard of Carl Jung, who looks very serious, and had the idea you could describe an individual's personality based on where they fell on four spectrums: the thinking spectrum, the feeling spectrum, the sensation spectrum, and the intuition spectrum. Later, Briggs and Myers adapted this idea into the Myers-Briggs Type Indicator. There are 8 personality characteristics in 4 either-or pairs. So you're either an introvert or an extrovert. You either sense or intuit things. You're either thinking or feeling, perceiving or judging. This means there are 16 personality types and ways that everyone can view or interact with the world. And it's also not scientifically sound. Ideally, on a personality test, you would see consistent results over time. But when a bunch of people took the Myers-Briggs test twice, 5 weeks apart, about 50% of them were a different personality type the second time around. But more importantly, the Myers-Briggs test doesn't have any real predictive power. Studies looking at how people respond in different situations found that your choices and behavior can't be explained by your Myers-Briggs type. Neither can how you perform in a job, what types of jobs you choose, or what you're like in relationships. So screenshot this and send it to the next person you come across with their Myers-Briggs type in their dating profile. Factors like agreeableness and conscientiousness are better indicators, which brings us to the Big 5. It's the most accurate personality test according to science and looks at 5 main traits: openness, conscientiousness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism. Everyone has each of these 5 traits to some degree, but the extent of these traits varies from person to person. Rather than lumping everybody into one of 12 or 16 groups, this type of test looks at where we fall on a spectrum of personality. Compared to any other personality test out there, the Big 5 gives the most consistent and valid results, meaning it has the ability to predict how you'll behave in the workplace or in relationships. Screenshot this and send it to your crush with no context. We're fascinated with the idea of personality types because we want to understand how we're similar and different and how we all fit into the world. But you're not a static type, and there's no evidence that tests like Myers-Briggs are accurate. What we can see is where you sit on a spectrum of personality traits. And this can be powerful because your personality traits can influence your well-being. People who are more agreeable and conscientious, for example, tend to experience higher life satisfaction and report feeling happier more often. But research has also found that your well-being can influence your personality traits. So if you want to be more agreeable and conscientious, you can try to boost your well-being by practicing gratitude, as well as visualizing your best possible self. So I'm sure it's not a big surprise to hear that easy online personality tests are wrong. But remember that the Big 5 is the most scientifically sound. It can tell you some things about who you are, but more so, you can use it to shape who you want to become. In some exciting news, it is the time of the year where we all do the PBS Digital Studios viewer survey. I'm hype, I hope you're hype. There's a link down in the doobly-doo. Honestly, I would be so appreciative if you could fill it out, say BrainCraft is your favorite show, because why not, and just let us know more about what you want to see here and on the wider Digital Studios network. Below that, as a reward, is a link to the Big Five personality test. So have fun. Bye.